Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is Absorption versus Variable Costing. This is part six. We're going to have a beginning and ending inventory, but this time we're going to be using LIFO. So let's get to it. Okay, so if I come over here to our part six or part five, wherever you might be. So over here, we're using LIFO. What does LIFO mean? It means last in, first out. And as you saw in the previous video, we talked about what happens with our inventory, right? And so let's just kind of give a little bit of a recap up here. So with my inventory, I'm starting out over here with my beginning inventory units plus my units produced gives me my units available for sale less my units sold. This is going to give me my units and my ending inventory. So over here, we have 10,000 units beginning, 50,000 produced, 60,000 units available for sale, sold 57, 3,000 units in my ending inventory. Okay, so over here, let's go ahead and take a look. So we're being asked to determine the cost per unit under variable and absorption costing. So this is going to be exactly the same as the past two videos, but I'll go ahead and do this anyways. So let's go ahead and do this real quickly. So under variable, I'm going to have my direct materials, my direct labor, my variable overhead, and then the fixed factory overhead. This is not applicable. So over here, my direct materials are 40 per unit. My direct materials are 50. My variable overhead, I'm going to take my variable overhead costs. I'm going to divide it by the units produced or 50,000 in the current year. I'm going to get $30 per unit. So my total cost per unit under variable costing is going to be 120. Under absorption, direct materials, the same, direct labor is the same, variable overhead's the same, but for my fixed factory overhead, this is going to be 4 million divided by 50,000 or $80 per unit. Okay, so my total cost per unit under absorption is going to be $200 per unit. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll do this time. Let's go ahead and do absorption. Okay, so absorption costing. I'm going to start with my sales. Okay, so I've got my units, my per unit, and my total. And let's give ourselves a nice big working space. Okay. All right. So over here, I sold 57,000 units. I'm selling it for $339 per unit. So my total sales under absorption costing are going to be $19,323,000. However, now what's a little bit different here, though, is when it comes to my cost of goods sold. If I'm doing LIFO, that means last in, first out. So the most recently produced units are the first to be expensed to cost of goods sold. So my current year, right, basically my current year cost of goods sold is basically going to be, when I go through and look at this, is going to be 50,000 units because this is what I produced this year. My per unit for this year is $200 per unit. So for a total over here of $10 million. Now, over here, for my beginning inventory cost of goods sold, I have 50,000 units so far. I need to take another 7,000 units. My per unit for these 7,000 units is going to be what? Well, in my beginning inventory, I'm going to have both variable costs and my fixed factory overhead. So this is going to be $255 per unit. Remember, I include them both under absorption costing. So this here is going to be $1,785,000. So my total cost of goods sold under absorption is going to be $11,785,000. Less my selling, general, administrative, I have sales commissions. This is going to be 57,000 units at $30 per unit, or a total of $1,710,000. I have my other SG&A, my fixed SG&A of 800,000. So my total SG&A is going to be 2,510,000. So my net income under absorption costing is going to be, oh, I forgot something here, guys. I am so, so sorry. I actually did this in one of my other classes. I don't know what it is. I guess I'm not getting grossed out enough. My gross profit is going to be 19,323,000, and this is going to give me 7,538,000. Yeah, something didn't look right. So my net income under absorption costing is going to be 5,028,000. Let's go ahead and take a look at variable costing. And this is under a LIFO, okay? Sales, always going to be the same under both. Okay. Less my cost of goods sold. I'm going to start LIFO, last in, first out. So my most recent costs are going to be the first ones expensed. So my current year variable COGS, this is going to be 50,000 units because that's how many units I produced. My per unit cost is 120. So this is going to be a total of 6 million. My beginning inventory variable cost of goods sold, this is going to be 7,000 units, right? Because I sold 57. I need to take 57,000 units to cost of goods sold. Over here, though, as we've seen before, I'm only going to expense the variable cost per unit because I previously expensed that beginning inventory units in the prior year. So over here, this is going to be 910,000. So my total cost of goods sold, I'm not even done yet. This is less my variable cost. I'm losing it. Too many videos in one day. Okay, am I done yet with my variable cost? Now I've got my sales commissions. This is going to be 57,000 at $30 per unit for a total of 1,710,000. So my total variable costs are going to be 6,910,000, 1,710,000. This is going to give me a contribution margin of 10,703,000. Less my fixed costs. I'm going to have fixed factory overhead. This is going to be $4 million. And then over here, I'm going to have my fixed SG&A. This is going to be 800,000. So my total fixed costs, this is going to give me 4.8 million. So my net income under variable costing is going to be 5,903,000. Now, let's compare these two. So over here, I've got net income under variable costing, which is 5,903,000. My net income under absorption costing is 5,028,000. For a difference here of 875,000. Now, in the last example, we had ending inventory that was coming from the current year production because we were using FIFO. But over here, what's really causing the difference? Well, this 4 million fixed factory overhead is being fully expensed, right? Because it's being expensed both in variable costing and an absorption costing, these we sold everything we produced in the current year. So what the difference has to be is going to relate to this beginning fixed factory overhead under absorption costing. If you look over here, I basically took to cost of goods sold from my beginning units to 55. I only did 130 here because it was expensed in the prior year. So for this particular example, if I take my beginning, my beginning fixed factory overhead, right? So this is going to be units, 7,000. My fixed factory overhead per unit is going to be 7,000 times 125 per unit. When I multiply 7,000 by 125, I get 875, right? It's always going to be that fixed factory overhead per unit, which is going to be causing it, right? So for this particular instance, this is why we're having a difference, is just because of that fixed factory overhead that we expensed in the prior year under variable, but it's now being expensed in the current year with cost of goods sold under absorption. So that brings us to the end of this particular video. I look forward to seeing you on the next one. And as we kind of look ahead, we just have two more to do. I'm going to give you 2 years of variable costing income statements. We're going to convert those to absorption, which is going to be a lot of fun. Then we're going to take 2 years of absorption and convert it to variable costing. So that's going to be, that's what will wrap us up. But I want to thank you for being here with me. Appreciate you liking and subscribing to videos. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.